Here's a poem for today, May 23rd, 2017, day 38. This is a poem disguised as a children's poem by A.A. Milne, titled The Dormouse and the Doctor. There once was a dormouse who lived in a bed of delphiniums blue and geraniums red. And all the day long he'd a wonderful view of geraniums red and delphiniums blue. A doctor came hurrying round and he said, "Tut, tut, I am sorry to find you in bed. Just say 99 while I look at your chest. Don't you find that chrysanthemums answer the best?" The dormouse looked round at the view and replied, when he'd said 99, that he'd tried, and much the most answering things that he knew were geraniums red and delphiniums blue. The doctor stood frowning and shaking his head, and he took up his shiny silk hat as he said, "What the patient requires is a change," and he went to see some chrysanthemum people in Kent. The dormouse lay there, and he gazed at the view of geraniums red and delphiniums blue, and he knew there was nothing he wanted instead of delphiniums blue and geraniums red. The doctor came back, and to show what he meant, he had brought some chrysanthemum cuttings from Kent. "Now these," he remarked, "give a much better view than geraniums red and delphiniums blue." So they took out their spades and they dug up the bed of delphiniums blue and geraniums red, and they planted chrysanthemums yellow and white. "And now," said the doctor, "we'll soon have you right." The dormouse looked out and he said with a sigh, "I suppose all these people know better than I. It was silly, perhaps, but I did like the view of geraniums red and delphiniums blue." The doctor came round and examined his chest and ordered him nourishment, tonics, and rest. "How very effective," he said as he shook the thermometer, "all these chrysanthemums look." The dormouse turned over to shut out the sight of the endless chrysanthemums, yellow and white. How lovely, he thought, to be back in a bed of delphiniums blue and geraniums red. The doctor said, "Tut, it's another attack," and ordered him milk and massage of the back and freedom from worry and drives in a car. He murmured, "How sweet your chrysanthemums are." The dormouse lay there with his paws to his eyes and imagined himself such a lovely surprise. "I'll pretend the chrysanthemums turn to a bed of delphiniums blue and geraniums red." The doctor next morning was rubbing his hands and saying, "There's nobody quite understands these cases as I do. The cure has begun. How fresh the chrysanthemums look in the sun." The dormouse lay happy. His eyes were so tight. He could see no chrysanthemums, yellow or white. And all he could feel at the back of his head were delphiniums blue and geraniums red. "And that is the reason," Aunt Emily said, "if a dormouse gets in a chrysanthemum bed, you will find," so Aunt Emily says, "that he lies fast asleep on his front with his paws to his eyes."